This is a re-upload. They blocked the last copy because I had a Dr. Phil clip in, so here's my Supdate Sunday video minus the copyright violation. Ugh. I know a few of you got to see it, and thanks so much for your positive comments. Hello everyone. Today for What's Up Sunday, someone asked me to do a video for them, so I'll read you what they wrote, analyzing as I go along. I'm sure everyone here can totally relate to this, so here goes. This comes from Down the Rabbit Hole Truth Seeker, and they say, in a nutshell, a narcissist wants supply, and they're going to create situations where they're going to abuse you. Here I might add, supply comes in more forms than attention. Sometimes it will be things such as money, or even just a place to live. And they are constantly creating dramas to either get supply, that is, your reaction, or cover up what they're really doing. I have found that it's usually the latter. It's like a sleight of hand. If they keep you confused, distracted, and attacking other people, then you won't notice what they're doing to you. Rabbit, they're going to lie, wreak havoc, triangulate people against you, hurt you, and you over time. This abuse builds up inside a normal person. Me, so yes, they're going to do all those things, and yes, this builds up in the victim over time. And I know a lot of people that have never been through narcissistic abuse say, well, why do you put up with it? And here's the insidious part of narcissistic abuse, you don't know you're being abused until after the fact usually. How can that be, they say. All these things they do, they don't do at once. It's like they have a barometer, and they balance the amount of abuse dished out. They go too far, then they pull back and love you again, etc. That's the emotional roller coaster you're kept on, and over time the abuse accumulates until the victim blows. Then, of course, that's the narcissist's proof that you're the abuser. It's all a very sick game, and make no mistake, a game it is. They are very aware of what they are doing to you, and, as I've pointed out in many videos, they are sadistic, so they're also enjoying your pain. And that pain is also supply. Rabbit, we call it crazy making, gaslighting, and we explode returning the pain to them, tell them the truth, our truth, and to them it is a severe narcissistic injury, because we hurt her little feelings. Me, and what Rabbit is describing here is what's called reactive abuse. Basically, do back to them what they've been doing to us all along, except at this point, because of the accumulated abuse, it can be explosive. Make no mistake, they may or may not have a narcissistic injury from this. In most cases, I would argue they do not, because the plan all along was to get you to this point. Chances are very good they already had one foot out the door, and were just creating an excuse to leave. In my experience, by the time the victim gets to this point, the discard has been in place for some time, you just don't know it yet. The narcissist is manufacturing, or engineering this situation, so when they leave they are the good guy and you are the bad guy. Rabbit, and the discard starts, because they now understand you will fight back, and now you are no longer fun to play with because your new reaction is not the same anymore. Me, again, I would argue that they discard started some time ago, your reaction was all part of the plan. Now, as sick as it sounds, they're just having fun with you. Definitely though, new reactions from you are game changers, but not in the way you're thinking. They love reactions, any and all reactions, and that makes you more fun to play with, not less. Remember, the only reaction they absolutely hate is no reaction at all, which will be next to impossible for you at this stage of the game. Rabbit, and now everything is the normal person's fault. You no longer are giving the reaction they love from you, shock. No wonder they do the smear campaign on you, because you took away the fun, and now they are mad at you for it, and revenge time. Me, yes, of course everything is the victim's fault, that's how narcissists operate, in their minds, nothing is ever their fault, and they refuse to be accountable. Here, again, I would say that the smear campaign was already well underway. Most narcissists start this at the very beginning of the relationship. They already know how things are going to go, because they've done it many times before. Also, the smear campaign isn't just for revenge, it's more practical than that. They have to convince everyone that you're the abuser, crazy, bipolar, drug addict, alcoholic, etc., to discredit you completely. Essentially, this is so that not a single person will believe a word you say. That way, when you try to tell people about the abuse, voila, they won't believe you. Bottom line is that, at the end of the day, they will need supply, and how are they going to get it, if no one wants to get near them? Creepy little buggers, aren't they? Rabbit, no different if you don't have any blood for a vampire. The vampire just do not care, and they no longer see you. So the hunt is now on for new blood slash supply, and they get supply from others when they smear campaign you. Me, they not only get supply from others, of course by presenting themselves as the victim, again, they discredit you, while hunting, or searching for their next victim. And, by the way, the new victim has more than likely already been lined up. Some narcissists, if they're not very good at the game, will use your breakup to play victim to ensnare their next victim, but like I said, he or she already has one in the stable at this point. And yes, the vampire analogy is perfect for the narcissist, because if you let them, they will damn you to hell, in more ways than one. Rabbit, that is why they waste their time doing it. Is a smear campaign really the same thing they were doing inside of the home with you? Me, yes, they do spend a lot of time doing it, but like I've said, it starts as soon as you first know them. And, yes, the smear campaign is incredibly, and sometimes irrevocably damaging, but it's not exactly the same as the abuse they do behind closed doors. That's really just for your eyes only, and why they have to smear you. They can't let anyone ruin the mask they've created for the public. That's how they get supply. If people were to know them for the monsters they really are, no one would ever be around them. Rabbit, but now it is outside of the home. Triangulation is what they were doing to your family members inside of the home to get supply. Now it just moved outside of the house. Me, triangulation is pretty much all they do. Remember the Karpman drama triangle, where you have three players, persecutor, hero, and victim. Narcissists will play one of these three roles all of the time. In fact, my ex-narc too was so pathological he could play all three roles within an hour. Talk about whiplash. So if you think about it, you could probably place your narcissist, at any given time, in one of these three roles. So, yes, triangulation is used during the smear campaign, and also for supply, but think of the practical applications as well. They have to discredit you in the end, completely, so no one believes what you say. As far as revenge is concerned, this is usually done in more stealthy ways, like destroying property, stealing, getting you fired from your job, etc. They want it to be painful, as well as personal. They want you to know it was them, but not to be able to prove it, if that makes sense. Rabbit, we for some reason a normal person is upset about this now, you would think we'd be used to it. This stuff is simple to figure out. Because of our emotions blocking the truth, we cannot see what happened, because we happen to have loved them, and love blocks our ability to see the truth. Me, I don't think a person ever gets used to narcissistic abuse, they will eventually fade away and become zombie-like, or kill themselves. It's an extremely lonely life with a narcissist, not to mention the insidious kind of abuse and neglect you have to endure. And I would disagree that this stuff is easy to figure out, quite the contrary, it's only in hindsight most figure it out, because it is so unthinkable. Normal, healthy brains just do not come up with the bizarre things narcissists do. Yes, I do agree that love is blind, but it's so much more than that. When you're dealing with a narcissist, you're dealing with a disordered personality structure. They think, emote, and feel completely different from a normal, healthy personality structure. But because they look so normal, and, in the beginning, do insane normal things, your expectations and impressions have been managed and set by them. Because you care about them, and have their best interest at heart, it's reasonable to assume that they have your best interest at heart as well. Sadly, that's never the case, and you find out, usually way too late, that they care about themselves only, and they're a fraud, a con, a liar, etc. Here's where your psychology comes into play. Because you've invested so much of your time, money, emotion, it takes a while to be able to admit to yourself that you were played. That's when the cognitive dissonance comes in, and if you let it, reality starts to paint the real picture of what has been going on, and that takes time. Rabbit, we are the crazy ones, because cannot understand what has been happening right in front of us, and we've been taking it personally. Me? No. We are not the crazy ones because we didn't catch onto the narcissist's game right away. We are the normal ones, and they use that against us. Because people, just 15 years ago or so, couldn't conceive of a narcissist, not to mention the things they are capable of doing, the victims suffered terribly alone, they felt crazy, blamed themselves, and literally had nowhere to turn. Now that awareness has exploded, more and more victims like you, Rabbit, come forward and tell their story, trying to understand the whys. I think the hardest part of this all is the betrayals, and with a narcissist, it's on every level of being. I think most of us still have moments of sadness, where we think to ourselves, how could I have not seen it? How could I have been so stupid? That's the thing about betrayal, it's one of the hardest traumas to overcome, because it shakes your faith in humanity to the very core. Betrayal changes you in many ways, and for most of us it means plotting out a new normal, forging ahead with newfound knowledge, confidence in our hard-won wisdom, and most of all, an intolerance for anything or anyone remotely toxic.